everybody, welcome to a new video. In today's video I'm not going to talk about any sewing project, but I'm going to talk about something that it has to do with sewing. So it is something very new to me, and I think is also pretty new to a lot of you that are using PDF patterns. So I think if you love PDF patterns, you'd love this product, because I think it's something really, really cool. First of all, this is no affiliate, how should I say, video. This beamer I bought it myself, so everything is only my opinion on it, so you should take it as it is, so it's nothing behind it. A few weeks ago I saw a message on Facebook about somebody who was using a projector to project her PDF files in the AO format, to project them directly on the fabric and cut the pieces directly and use them to make the project. Well, I was not so I did not find it such a great idea, because I always know that I need to make changes on my patterns, like for shoulders and sway back and bust adjustments. So I did not find it a very special thing, because I knew that I still need to have the paper. The idea is to skip the printing of the paper and taping and all those things, so to project directly on fabric. For me it didn't work, or the idea wasn't working for me, but I was thinking that it could be something, because if I can project the patterns directly on a piece, big piece of paper, then I can trace that from the beamer, and then I can cut it off and use it on paper, so not on fabric. So, and by that I will skip the printing of the patterns and taping and those steps before having the pieces to use. So with that in mind, I went a little bit to look around for a beamer, and I came to see the Facebook group Projectors for Sewing, I think it's called, and there you'll find a lot of information, a lot of people that are asking about the setup with a beamer, or people that have already one and how they did it. So I looked around there, and somebody was talking about the Ota Mini Projector projector, and she also had a very cool mount for it, for the floor mount, so that is standing on the floor and not on the ceiling. I didn't want something for the ceiling, because you know, that is hanging from there. My ceiling is not straight, and I if you need to charge this thing, I'm thinking that you need to put it down, or you need to have like a power net there upstairs to be able to charge it. So with all those things in mind, I made a list with the things I wanted to have on my beamer, and with that I went searching on the internet. And if you are going to do that, you'll get crazy, because there are so many choices and you really don't know what is going to work and what not. And I, for a few days, I was completely going crazy trying to decide on one. And finally, the things that I wanted to have, they were the following. So I was looking for something that it had at least 200 lumens, because I wanted to be able to use it also when it's pretty much daylight in my studio, and not having to make everything dark to be able to see the light, so the projector. So I wanted to have at least 200 lumens. I wanted to have it wireless, that I could move it around my table without having cables everywhere. I also wanted to have a possibility for screen mirroring, because I want to use my phone. So I'm using my phone with an Xodo app, that I can, when I connect the phone to the beamer, I can control it with my phone, and everything what I see on my phone I can see it on the table, and that is great. So I wanted the screen mirroring function. Another thing, it was the fact that it has a remote control, and if I want to put it on or off, and it is already high and mounted, I can use a remote control to put it on and off, so I don't need to climb on a stair to push a button. That was also something. And I didn't want something really big because there are some that sometimes some of these projectors can be really heavy, like 3 kilos or something like that, or even 2 kilos. I found it a little bit heavy, so I wanted something very light. And with all those things that I wanted, I started to look what is the price that I need to pay for all the things I wanted. And to be honest, there is also a very big difference, and it's also depending in which continent you are, because you'll pay for a beamer like, I don't know, for any brand. Maybe you'll pay in the United States like $300, and in Europe you will pay maybe $500. So it's really a big difference. But with all the things I wanted, I started to look at the prices, and finally I decided on this Ota Mini projector. It's the T7 model, and it has all the things I said, like wireless screen mirroring for iOS and Android. It has also it has a good battery, and also another plus is that it has a battery that I can, so the possibility that when I'm using it and the battery is low and I need to charge it, I can continue, I can plug in the charger and I can continue working. Some of them you'll not have the possibility to charge the projector and work in the same time. You'll have to let it charge and then to work with it. So this one had all those things I wanted. It's also pretty light. It has only 430 grams. It has also something that I was looking for. It was how I'm going to mount this thing and to put it to project on my table. So the projector, the lens is here on the front. It should be used like this. And it has here on the underside, it has a small hole where you can mount something and then to put it on your mount. Other things that it has two USB ports and a HDMI port, also a port for earplugs, so, and also for you can put an SD card. So this is what I chose for my purpose for projecting the files. So it came also with a remote control, and you can do everything with this. You have also, I have also buttons for focus, to focus this. It doesn't focus automatically, so you need to do it yourself, but it's really really easy and it's working very very easy. It has also some cool adjustments that I can make for zoom and for color and for all kind of things to get a really great screen. It has also a small stand, but it's really really small and I'm not going to use this, and a small bag. This is also something that I got in the package. So after I got it, I tried to connect my phone, and by phone I mean an Android phone. I did not have any iOS, and everywhere where I was reading about it, there were people that did use Apple devices to connect to this beamer, and everything was working perfect. And I did read a few reviews about people trying to connect Android phones and that it did not work. So the first day when I got it, I tried a lot of hours to get the thing work with different apps and stuff like that, but I could not connect my phone, my Samsung phone, to it for the screen mirroring. So finally, and this is something that maybe you can use with other beamers that don't have the possibility for screen mirroring, I got the idea to use a Chromecast, and I have here, this is the Ultra Chromecast. To use it, I connected to the beamer, and then I could screen mirror my phone to it. It was really it was perfect, and this is the Ultra version of the Chromecast. You can use it also if you attach USB cable. You can connect to this thing and then to your projector, and then you have also the whole thing wireless, so it will only hang here on the projector, but you'll be free to move around. So I used this thing, and I was convinced that I cannot connect my Android devices to the beamer. And it happened that I had to order another cast dongle for a TV we have here in the house. And I tried that one. I tried it also with this Beamer. And I need to say that it happened something very strange. I could not get a calibration right with that dongle, with that wireless dongle. So instead of getting squares on my for my calibration or my patterns, I got only how should I say, rectangles. So it was with the cheaper dongle, it really did not work. I have no idea why. If you know, please put it in the comment. I would really love to know why. But when I returned to the Google Chrome, it worked really perfect again. My squares, they were all square. And I found it really, you know, not fine that I could not connect my phone without having all kind of other things hanging around. So I wrote an email to the company where I bought it, and they said that I could do an update. And I did that when I got the thing, but it still did not work. But now they said do an update and everything would work, and it did. So now I have I'm only connecting, and I'm going to show you soon in the video, at the end of the video, I can connect the phone to the Beamer with the screen mirroring app or function that it is built in the Beamer. I can connect it very easy. I'm going to show you in a few minutes how, and then I can project the pattern onto my table very easy, and without having any other cables hanging around. So that is really great. The only thing is that you need to have the possibility to connect your Beamer with the Wi-Fi and to be on the same Wi-Fi with your Android phone, so, or iOS, and then everything is going to get really easy. So this was done. I was happy with it. And about the mount I had to buy, the only thing I was thinking when I had to choose the mount for this Beamer, it was if the mount will go high enough to get a good image here on my table, because I am using this to project the patterns on the paper. It's really not so important for me how much of that AO file is getting projected on the table. So I tried yesterday evening, I think I had something like a meter wide and like half meter high. So that is a good screen size for me. And I'm going to show it to you, then you can I can move the pattern on my screen and I can trace all the pieces I need. So I can imagine that for people that want to have that the whole pattern, AO pattern is getting projected on the table, you have to have a very big table, and also you have to go really high with your mount. But I did not need that. So with that in mind, I decided, and I'm going to put a picture here. I'm going to show it soon to you, but I'm going to put a picture here to the side. I decided to buy a newer mount that and they are from a few different brands also, but I decided for newer because I have also my lamps from them, and I knew that the quality is pretty good. And for the mount I had to pay 75 euros. That is a price, but when I got the thing, it is really heavy, and I still think that for this little thing is still a little bit overkill. But if you have a Beamer that is a little bit heavier, I think you should have a very steady mount that is not going to move around and get all shaky, you know. So I'm really happy with it. A few words about the stand. It can go so forth from the floor up on the first, so the vertical thing can go to 181, to 1 meter and 81 centimeters, and in combination with the other with the horizontal thing, you can get even higher. And I measured yesterday, I think I need around 95 centimeters from the table. Of course, it depends how high your table is. But with my table that is around, I think it's around 80 centimeters or something like that. Yeah, and then I have 95 centimeters with my beamer is really high enough. So this is something that you need to take into consideration, how high you can go and what you need, how high is your table. And I think for me, I think around 95 centimeters is giving a good projected image on my table. This is also something that you really need to consider when choosing your beamer. The size of the screen that is projected on how much distance you need to have. And there is, I think I'm going to put that in the description. There is a website where you can really calculate the setting you have, the table, the height of the table and the height of the room. And then you can put there all the information there and you can see if a particular beamer that you choose, it will work for your setup. So this is everything that I needed, so the beamer and the good mount, and I was ready to go, and I'm going to show you now how I mount it in my room, and I'm going to demonstrate it, to demonstrate how it's working on the Olivia bralette from Designer Stitch, a new pattern from Designer Stitch that is also projector friendly. It has the possibility to put the layers on and off like you normally do in an A4 digital pattern. So that is really, really cool. And it has also the possibility to choose the layer for the inch grid that you get all kind of the whole image. You get the 1 inch calibration square, and that is really, really cool because you can be really accurate about it. And for that I'm using the Xodo app. Is the only one. I tried a few yesterday, but this is the only one that is really working with the layers and all kind of and the zooming and everything is really, really perfect for this setup. So the Xodo app with an AO projector friendly pattern, and I'm going to show you how it's working. The first thing I need to do is to attach this thing on the projector, and then I can put everything very easy in the stand. I'm going to screw it in, not too hard, and now this is ready to be attached on the mount. Okay, let's see. I have here the projector with that thing in. So I want to have it, this is where the lens is. I want to have it, of course, that is going to project downwards. And this thing is really, really cool because it has the possibility I can mount it here in this hole. So I can mount it like this, and it's going to project here, or I can mount it like this. You know, if you want to put something else, you know, I can use this also to use it with my video cam or with my photo cam, and it has really a lot of possibilities for adjustments. And so before I put that the beamer on, it can go from here, it can go higher, it can really go to more than 2 meters. From this thing here, it can really go up and down. It has also 3 or 4 kilo extra weight that I have there that I can balance if I'm using something much heavier. And it can also, this thing, it can also go up and down, and then as you can see I can also get even much higher than now. So it has all kind of possibilities, and this thing, it also can, if I let it here, I can also turn it in many ways. So it's really a really great one. Let's say I'm going to use it like this, and I'm going to turn this again. That is a little bit straight. And this can even go higher. So it's a really great great mount that it gives a lot of possibilities in length and position. So let's see, I have the beamer here and I'm just going to stick it here in. I hope you can see that. Of course you need to be sure that everything is secure and that it's not going to fall. So I have it like this, and then the next step for me, it was to see exactly where I want to have it on the table and how high I want it. I'm going to make the setup and then I'm going to meet you back to show you how everything is looking on the table. Is mounted, and this is the start screen of it. I tried to make the image a little bit small that it will fit in the video cam, so I don't have to go with the video camera too high for you to get the whole screen. At this moment is around 95 centimeters from the table to the beamer. And this is how the start screen of this particular beamer is looking. To make connection with my phone, I need to go to the Miracast here, because I'm using an Android device. If you have an Apple, I think you should use the AirPlay. So for me, I need to have the Miracast. And I'm here. And if you are using Google Chromecast to get wireless with your projector, you should use the HDMI button, and then you follow the menu and you get the connection. So now I'm using the Miracast. I'm going to press that. Here is a little bit of instructions, and this is now searching from my phone. Here is my phone. I'm going to set it to put it on smart view. And that will be here, and then it's finding all kind of devices, and I need to have the Mcast, and I'm going to start, and it is ready to play, and this is the this is my phone. Okay, so now I have the screen mirroring on, and the next step is to start the Xodo app. Here, push it on. Now I have already a pattern on here, but I'm going to choose another one, and I'm going to do that by clicking. Let's see here. And I have my patterns, the ones I loaded in the folders, and I have here the Olivia bralette. And now it's on my screen, and of course on the projector. I'm going to turn my phone, and you should have the landscape or the automatic turn on your phone on. And I'm going to push this away. And now I have the pattern. So the most important thing is at this point to square your screen. I did already on mine, so I know that I have all these are the height and the length of the image are exactly the same. And now onto the pattern. You adjust that either with moving your projector a little bit to the left, the right, or I have in this particular projector there is a function, the trapez correction or something like this, and I can adjust each side. I can adjust to make it on the correct square. What I'm projecting now on a piece of plotter paper, because I have two big rolls of papers that I'm going to use also in the future to trace my patterns. But I have here underneath I have my cutting mat, and I can use this also to be sure that my image is completely square. So this is how the pattern is looking now. Let's see. I'm going to in this app, in the Xodo app, you have the possibility to, let me see, you have the possibility to choose the layers. So you have the three points here, and then you have view layers, and here are all the sizes. So I'm going to take a few sizes away. 5 and I'm going to leave only size 3, which is my size. Okay, I have the pattern information on the tealing boards, and I'm going to use also the 1-inch calibration, and then I get that raster on the image that I can really calibrate everywhere that I have a 1-inch calibration correctly, because of course it's very, very important to have an accurate 1-inch calibration to have the patterns on the true size. So the next step is now to be sure that these squares are 2 inches or 1 inch, excuse me, and the big ones here are 2 inches. And how you do that? You are just going to zoom in and zoom out and measure to be sure that you have the correct measurement. Let's see where we have the 2 inches. I hope you can see, this is really, I'm going to zoom in a little bit. Let's see, where is my, okay, as you can see here, this is my 2.5 inch, and I'm going to pinch this a little bit to make it a little bit, I'm doing it on my phone, to make it a little bit smaller. Let's see, it's just about to be, here is a 2.5, I think it's missing just tiny bit. Let's see, and there you have it, the 2.5. So I have 2.5 here, and if I am to move this, I have also 2.5. And what I want to say, as I was saying earlier in my video, with the Chromecast, with the cheaper version of the Chromecast, I really could not get the square. I was getting only rectangles. So that was that is really something that I think it has to do with the connection or with the streaming devices you are using. So let's see. We are back on the pattern. I'm going to turn this. I just put it off. Okay, and as I see here, my focus is a little bit off, so on my remote control I have a button here. There are some beamers that they have automatic focus, but I'm going to fix this, and this is good enough for me. I can see the pattern pieces very well. My squares are checked. I have a 2.5 centimeter grid on my projecting on my paper, so now I can just easily start to trace all these things. And I'm going to use a, let's see, I'm just going to trace around. I think it's very, very easy, and I know I'm going to make some dashed lines, and this is of course going to be much, much faster than printing the A4 and taping everything together. Some people, they are even cutting those edges. And I have here, I know that it's crotch pattern 3, and I can use a ruler to make the grain lines. And of course, if I want to move then here, I can also move the paper away around, because I know that everything is staying steady. I think the great, I can also use the ruler to have straighter lines. The great thing about having a mount on the floor and not like a gooseneck on the table is that when you are working, that you don't have the chance that you are going to move the table, and then to get of course the wrong information on your or that your calibration is going to change or to move or stuff like that. I know this is the back, and it's cut 1 on fold, and this is how I'm going to use this projector. If you have any questions, put them in the comments. I'll do my best to answer them. If you have any questions about the beamer or about I don't know, the mount or how I'm using them, please put them in the comments, and I'm going to give you my best answers that I can. So as you can see, I moved a little bit the image around in my phone, and then I'm going to move the paper a little bit around, and then I'm going to trace the next piece, like this one here. It's very, very easy, and it's definitely going to take me much lesser, and I'm going to use, let's see, I'm going to use much lesser paper than when I was to tape everything away together. And sometimes I also trace patterns again, because I'm not sure if one size is going to fit me. And can you imagine if you need to print a few times and then tape everything together, then it's going to take a really, really long time. And these are my pieces. And if I'm going to put the beamer off, you can really see my pieces, how nice and straight they are, and they are ready to be cut off. Anyways, I hope this video was helpful for you in this new adventure with using projectors for the PDF patterns. I am sure I'm going to get a lot of use from it, and I think the most challenging part is first choosing the right projector for you, and then in all the process I think the most important thing is the calibration in the beginning of the setting when you are starting with your pattern, to calibrate well your image that is getting projected, to be sure that your pattern is are not distorted, and that you know, you'll get wrong cutted pieces. Again, for me this is going to work only for projecting on paper and not on fabric, and cutting fabric directly with the projections on them, because I'm not using that. I need to have the pattern changes, and I need to have the patterns on paper. I hope this video was helpful. Don't forget, you can put your questions in the comments, and I'll do my best to answer them. And if you like the video, subscribe to my channel for upcoming videos with a projector, and also with other sewing projects. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!